Hello everyone, myself Nagaraj H Koppa, working as an assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in the present video lecture, I am going to explain about derivation of bearing capacity equation. So these are the learning outcomes from the video lecture. At the end of this session, student will be able to derive Terzaghi's bearing capacity equation. So these are the contents present in the video lecture. So this is a picture which is related to derivation part. In the previous video lecture, already I have explained assumptions of Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory. So based on the assumptions bearing capacity theory, so it is a drawn picture which is related to bearing capacity equation. So as usual, it is a footing which is carrying the load Qu. Ground condition is horizontal, gamma, once again unit weight of soil sample, gamma into df is nothing but overburden pressure, therefore p equal to gamma into df at the base of footing. So here we are dividing entire this zones into three components. One is active zone, second one radial shear zone, third one passive zone. So active zone, in the active zone, soil is in limit equilibrium state. So due to the overburden pressure, there is inducing passive zone. So due to the presence of passive zone as well as active zone, there may be chances of inducing radial shear zone. We are calling it as zone number 2. So angle at A equal to 5, angle at B is also 5. Due to the condition of limit equilibrium of soil sample, angle at CAB equal to angle at CBA. This Qu is vertical and symmetrical. Therefore, here, due to the presence of Qu, the PP, passive pressure, is acting in upward direction at an angle of phi, and C, which is acting in inclined direction. So where C is nothing but cohesion of soil sample. So here we have to calculate. First, we have to calculate weight of wedge. So weight of wedge, we have to calculate weight of wedge ABC. Now, weight of wedge, angle at A and angle at B are equal. It is angle at A, it is 5, angle at B is also 5. By using this picture, we have to calculate weight of wedge. Weight of wedge ABC equal to, now I will apply tan rule for this figure. Tan phi equal to opposite divided by adjacent. Opposite is x, adjacent is b by 2. Therefore, tan phi equal to x divided by b by 2. Therefore, now x equal to b by 2 into tan phi. Basically, we know that gamma equal to w by v, where gamma is nothing but unit weight of soil sample divided by volume of soil sample. Therefore, what we want to calculate now? We want to calculate weight of soil sample, therefore gamma into v. Therefore, w equal to gamma into v. W equal to, once again, substitute all the values above values in the equation. Gamma into 2 into 2 times of this area, 2 times of triangle. It means first triangle as usual. So it is a right side triangle and left side triangle. Therefore, two triangles, half into base into height. So b by 2, it is base, x is height. Therefore, x equal to b by 2 into tan phi. So substitute all the values in the equation. Here we got weight of wedge equal to 1 by 4 into gamma into p square into tan phi. Now, downward force equal to upward force. So, for this figure, let's make this equation downward force equal to upward force. What are the downward forces now? So, Qu into B, it is a downward force. Weight of wedge is also acting in downward force. PP, it is acting in upward direction. C is also acting in upward direction. Therefore, now, Qu into B plus 1 by 4 into gamma into B square into tan phi equal to 2 PP. Here, PP for right side, PP for left side. Therefore, PP plus PP, 2 PP. 2 PP plus 2 C Li sin phi. So, cohesion which is acting in inclined direction. Therefore, Li into sin phi. Now, we have to calculate Li. Li for CB surface, Li for CA surface. Let's, I will talk about CB surface. CB equal to, once again, apply cos rule for this triangle. CB equal to B by 2 divided by cos pi. Let's substitute this b by 2 divided by cos pi in the equation number 1. Therefore, equation number 1 becomes qu into b plus 1 by 4 into gamma into b square into tan phi equal to 2 times of passive pressures plus 2c. So Li is nothing but b by 2 into 1 divided by cos pi into sin phi. Sin phi divided by cos pi is nothing but once again tan phi. Therefore, qu into b equal to 2pp plus b into c tan phi minus 1 by 4 gamma into b square into tan phi. So take this term 1 by 4 gamma into b square into tan phi towards right side, it becomes once again negative. So final equation number 2, it becomes qu into b equal to 2pp plus b into c tan phi minus 1 by 4 gamma into b square into tan phi. Let us consider passive pressure which is resulting into three components. One is due to unit weight of soil, due to cohesion of soil, due to surcharge load Q. If we are considering cohesion term, it means unit weight of soil sample and surcharge load both becomes ignorable quantity. If we are considering gamma term, gamma is nothing but unit weight of soil sample. Therefore, while calculating surcharge weight, overburden pressure Q equal to once again gamma into DF. Therefore, we must consider once again unit weight of soil sample. So C becomes ignorable quantity. So QU into B equal to 2 times of PP, gamma plus PP, cohesion plus PP related to surcharge. So plus B into C tan phi minus 1 by 4 gamma into B square into tan phi. So let us consider 2 times of PP with respect to cohesion equal to C into NC, 2PP with respect to surcharge weight Q into NQ, 2PP with respect to unit weight of soil sample, half into B into gamma into N gamma. So NC, N gamma and NQ are related to bearing capacity factors. So when we are considering bearing capacity factors NC, NQ and N gamma, so 1 by 2 it becomes ignorable quantity. So B into C it is once again ignorable quantity. Therefore QU into B equal to, so substitute all the values in the equation, BC into NC plus BC B into Q into NQ plus half into B square into gamma into N gamma. So common term is B. So BB get cancels. At last finally equation QU equal to C into NC plus Q into NQ plus half into B into gamma into N gamma, where Q is nothing but ultimate bearing capacity of soil, cohesion of soil, so overburden pressure, base of footing, unit weight of soil sample, NC, NQ and N gamma are Terzaghi's bearing capacity factors. We are going to determine Terzaghi's bearing capacity factors by this chart. So general shear failure and local shear failure for corresponding friction angle. So these are the NC value, NQ value and N gamma value. Now you may pause the video, and the correct answers are the parameters NC, NQ, N gamma in the equation of bearing capacity failure are known as bearing capacity factors. So what is the value of N gamma for 35 degree? So it is 42.4 from this chart. For corresponding 45 degree, the value of N gamma, so it is 42.4. So these are the references for the preparation of this video lecture. Thank you.